Hi, hello. I'm sorry that I can't attend the meeting in person due to the visa issues. I can only share my talk through the video. Today, I will introduce my work. I have re-implemented Git storage and transfer protocol using Rust. This has enabled me to create a Monorepo engine and a decentralized code collaboration network. I'm Quanyi from Huawei. I'm also a board member of the Web3 Infrastructure Foundation, a Hong Kong-based open source foundation that supports Web3 infrastructure open source project. You can find me on Twitter, Gmail, or GitHub using the edition. First, let's talk about the monorepos. It is just what it sounds like, one big folder for all your code. Think of it as keeping all your companies working in one place. It's easier to share stuff and keep everyone on the same page. When everyone's working from the same spot, it's simpler to stay in sync. But here, the catch, when it gets too big, it can slow things down. Now, Polyrepo is different. Here, you split things up. Each project gets own space, like giving each team its run its own room. This way, you can control who sees that, and the team can work at their speed. But there's a downside. It can get tricky when projects need to use the same folder or parse. Ensuring everyone using the last version of everything can be a real headache. Let's look how Google, Meta, or Microsoft handle monorepos with their companies. By January 2015, Google's paper held 18.6 terabyte of content with 35 million commits and over 1 million files. Paper is a mass code repository built on Google infrastructure called Spanner. Is spread across 10 Google data centers worldwide, ensuring global data consistency. Google also integrates a cloud-based client to make it easy for developers to leverage Piper's capabilities fully. However, it's essential to know that Piper is not open source. Meta uses a system called Sapling to manage its vast code base. Sapling is integrated with a server named MonoNook, which store code in a database similar to how Google's Piper uses Spanner. This mass combines SQL on SQLite and file system backends. Sapling is designed to handle tens of millions of files and commits and long. Unlike Piper, Sapling is open source. Microsoft created Scalar is a fork of Git to help developers managing large repositories on their local machines. Scalar has features like partial cloning, background profiling, and file system monitoring to improve the Git experience for big projects. Scalar relies on the GVFS protocol, but while Scalar is open source, there isn't an open source GVFS server available. Since Git is the world's most popular version control system, let's discuss using it to host the monorepo. Git offers two native solutions for monorepos, Git submodule and subtree. Think of the Git submodule as a one-way link. In a monorepo, you can't directly update the repository within a submodule. Instead, you update them in their separate repositories and then integrate, test, deploy this change in main monorepo. On the other hand, Git subtree works more like a two-way link. This allows code updates in both the main monorepo and the sub-repositories. However, managing complex dependency can become tricky with their others. If you're dealing with the nested structs, it can quickly lead to confusion and chaos. Git doesn't offer an ideal solution for handling monorepos with a terabyte of source code. If you want to benefit from Git, While efficiently managing a monorepo, a setup similar to Google's Piper or Meta's sampling could be answered by store Git data in a database. Leveraging the database distributed filters, you can create a monorepo structure that combines the best of both Git and the distributed database system for a smoother experience. Think of the Git as a super smart camera for your code. Each time you make a change, it takes a picture. This picture is called a snapshot. Now, Git doesn't just throw all this picture in a big pile. It's more organizing than that. It puts things in different boxes. The blob box is where you keep the actual stuff you write, your code, your text, whatever. The tree box is like a map showing where everything goes in your folder. The commit box is where the Git write down who made changes and why. To ensure everything stays organized and secure, Git use a hash. It's like a unique fingerprint for each piece of data. The fingerprint is calculated based on the data, so even the tiniest change will result in a completely different hash. This helps Git quickly find and retrieve the files you need, even if it's stored on other computers. Even if you try to use a fancy distributed file system to spread the load, it still struggles to keep up with all those tiny code changes. This needs to be more overhead, and sadly, there aren't any open source distributed file system designed for the Git needs. So what's the solution? Big companies like Google and Meta have figured out that a clever workaround. They store their source code directly in a database. This lets them leverage the power of distributed database, which are built on handle massive amount of data and keep everything in sync, even across multiple teams and locations. In short, to tame a giant monorepo, you should give up the traditional file system and embrace the power of the database. So we re-implemented Git's internal storage using the Rust and develop a monorepo engine. When developers commit code, the engine decodes the transmitted pack file according to the Git protocol and store all the Git objects in a database. When developer clones the code, the engine retrieves the data from the database based on the path in the monorepo repository, encode this, and return in Git pack file format. During this progress, we realized that 100 compatibility with the Git would be require significant work. To address this, we developed a CLI tool that workers alongside with the monorepo engine. These tools use a Superlite database to closely mirror Git's structure, ensuring as much compatibility as possible while simplifying integration with the monorepo engine. We named the open source project Mega, and it's available on GitHub under the Web3 Infrastructure Foundation organization. We encourage everyone to check out and give us your feedback. And of course, once Mega matures, we plan to use it to host our own code as well. CRISPR is a research project from Nanjing University of China, focused on analyzing all Rust open source projects on GitHub to recommend the most suitable creator for the developers. This project uses Mega as the backend code storage service, storing the code be analysis. By leveraging Mega, CRISPR improves the efficiency of reading code during the analysis process. Both Google and Meta have robust build systems that work hand in hand with their monorepos. Google uses the Bazel, while Meta has open source their Rust-based build system, Back2. We are choosing to integrate with Back2 with Mega, we are actually collaborating with the CRISPR teams to streamline their DevOps workflows. Then let's talk about the decentralized service. Git is the most popular version control system, have no central dependency, allowing developers to work independently with completed repository copies. This makes it perfect to distribute team. Developers can work offline, making commits and branches and sync later. Git flexibility lets team to choose between central coordination and independent work. GitHub built on Git is a user-friendly hub for storing and collaborating on projects. It offers features like fork pull requests and issue tracking, making collaboration easy. However, being centralized, GitHub holds significant power over hosted projects. It can access all data and can take action like training AI or deleting projects. So we want to build a decentralized open source collaboration. First, we don't want to invent a new version control system or change developers' behavior. So we need a Git compatible host service as a middle layer with a decentralized ability. All the Git host service nodes connect and no centralized node exists. Each service can get pieces of code from different nodes that it wants, not limited by the Git protocol. To get code from one repository service is our data layer. Second, when the developer open source a repository or submits a merge request, the Git host service broadcasts an event compatible with the decentralized social network protocol like Matrix, Nostr, and others. Any node subscribed to the event tab will be notified and do what it wants. It's our collaboration layer. We want a simple way to build a decentralized network, so we choose the ZTM, Zero Trust model. ZTM is open source software that makes running a decentralized network easy. It works over regular internet connection and can be used on any type of network. One big benefit of ZTM is that a simple network setup. We could connect our Git hosting service directly to the ZTM, so we didn't to worry about compatible network stuff. This free up our developers to focus on the more important parts of Omega. ZTM is an excellent fit to decentralized network because it's scalable, secure, and flexible. It can handle large networks, keep data safe with the encryption, and has a modular design and make it easier to add new features. Git LFS helps managing large files in the Git, but not enough to fully address the challenge posed by the increasing size of larger language model. To tackle this issue, Mega is developing a solution beyond the Git LFS protocol. We are working on splitting large files into small pieces to delivering them through a decentralized network. This approach makes it easier to handle mass files and ensure efficiency and a reliable distribution across the network, addressing the limitation of traditional mass like the Git LFS. So let's demo. We are wrapped our Monorepo engine using Terry, turn it into a user-friendly app that any developer can install. Once the apps run, you can push and pull code directly to your local Monorepo engine, giving you complete control over your code. After starting Monorepo, you have the option to connect a relay node with an open source code. The network built using the ZTM enable collaboration between all connected network. So you can publish or open source any directory within your monorepo. This information will be broadcast across the network, and the relay node sharing it with all the apps, so you can see in the repos. So let's see the another app in the meeting. It's a different location. Another app can choose the choose to clone your the open source project into their monorepo. If the direct network connection can be established between the two apps with AAT, all data transfer happens directly between them. If a direct connection isn't possible in some network, so the data will securely relayed through the relay node using the encryption. The Moxin is a Rust-based large model app that using the Mega to build a decentralized distribution network for large models. The goal is to shift the distribution of open source large models from a centralized system to a decentralized one. If it's an exciting step because if it works, it could change how we think about sharing and accessing this powerful AI tools. It's all about making advanced AI more accessibility and communicate web. Finally, here's our roadmap. We are currently in the first phase, the prototyping stage, and a few projects and the open source projects have already chosen Mega as their backend service. We achieved this thanks to the advantages provided by the Rust programming language. It allows us to focus on more on future development instead of spending countless hours debugging memory issues. We hope more Rust developers will take notice of our project and join us on this future. Okay, that's all. Thank you.